10 Cats Does Countdown. John Richardson. Lee Mack. Sarah Milliken. James Acaster. Dr. John Cooper Clark. Susie Dent. And Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, a baby porcupine is called a porcupet? Porcupet is also a chat-up line in Newcastle. Tolkien typed the 1,200-page manuscript of Lord of the Rings using only two fingers. I bet that was bloody Mordor. And amen is the last word in the Bible. God says it, and then he drops the mic and crowd surfs out on a bunch of lepers. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's John Richardson. John recently filmed a documentary about irrational fears. What if they're not irrational, John? What if you are boring and everyone does hate you? And John's teammate, James Acaster. Thank you. Where would James be without comedy? Well, I imagine hanging out at a games workshop wondering what it's like to touch a girl's boob.
I'm still doing half of those things.
Up against them is special guest team captain Lee Mack.
Hi.
Lee excelled at school. Sorry, Lee was expelled at school. And joining Lee tonight, Sarah Milliken. Hello. Sarah founded the online feminist magazine Standard Issue. If you want to check it out, ladies, it's easy. Just get your husband or your dad to set it up on the computer for you. Well, if that got me in trouble, I might as well go all in. OK.
The classic Jimmy Carr catchphrase.
You set up Standard Issue, right?
Yes.
Well, tell us a little bit about it. What is it?
Oh, it's a no-bullshit women's magazine. Cos I don't like women's magazines generally. Cos I don't care about the things that they write about. So we set up one that has things that our women are interested in, which is, you know, everything.
So a no-bullshit women's magazine... Cos normal women's magazines have just... It's just adverts for bags. Like, if you buy Vogue...
Do you buy women's... Well, maybe you do, cos you could get tips on how to creosote your face, for example.
If I go on it, will they know that I'm a man having a sneaky peek?
I don't know why
I've
you
been
would...
on it, they can't tell.
Well, it's levels of testosterone, so maybe you'd be all right.
OK, Sarah is from the Northeast, and fun fact, human beings share 99.9% of our DNA with Geordies.
A sand dancer, so South Shields.
But a sand dancer?
Yeah, but it sounds rubbish, doesn't it?
My hometown is Southport and they are the sand grounders.
Just, really?
Not all comedy, some of it's information.
My hometown is Lancaster and we call ourselves Lancastrians because we don't like to take the piss.
James, where are you from and what do they call you lot?
I'm from Kettering and they call us legends.
OK, Lee, I mean, you strike me as quite a wise man. What's your motto in life?
Well, I've got quite a few, actually, Jim. I've got quite a lot of mottos. First of all, my motto in life is never put off until tomorrow what can be put off until the day after tomorrow. never return to a lit firework unless you're pretty sure it's probably gone out. Girls do just want to have fun, but apparently not with me. And finally, if life gives you lemons, say, I'm sorry, life, I didn't ask for lemons, I asked for a hot girlfriend in a speedboat.
I mean, all good. Sarah, you recently tweeted about unblocking a toilet with a bath mat.
That's a good one, isn't it?
How did you...?
Well, all you need to unblock a toilet is basically creating a vacuum. And I just got the, you know, the bath mat, and I just sort of did that a bit, and it... And
was, then it I just... the, was it rubber?
Yeah. Did it it wasn't like a fluffy
So you get... Because you need purchase, don't you? You need a bit of you need something...
And then you just cover the hole, and you just do that for ages, and then all good. And then you just, you know, chuck the bath mat in the bath.
Have you got any other housekeeping tips? Any other...?
This is a good one.
OK, go on.
If you ever have to keep a dog poo in your fridge... I've had to, because the dog wasn't very well, so I had to take samples 3 days in a row. So you have to keep the first two fresh before you take them to the vet. Makes total sense. And I thought, well, whereabouts in the fridge? And then I realised, salad crisper, because there's never anything in it.
OK. James, is it fair to say you're a bit of an oddball?
Clearly not. I'm pretty cool. Pretty happening guy in most of my circles. If I venture outside of those borders, opinions vary.
Do you think you're cooler than John?
Here's something you've got to know early doors, Jimmy. Coolness is not a competition. Me and John, we hit the town sometimes together.
Ooh.
In the daytime to do some shopping. Best time to hit the town, where everyone's there and the shops are open and everyone knows our name at certain shops.
Well, that's because you're probably wearing name tags.
We do wear name tags. And do you know what? Once, do you remember this? We swapped him around for a laugh. His name's not James.
I didn't realise he would be such a titty toucher.
Guilty!
OK, John, what's your favourite party game?
Oh, Turn It Down.
what's Turn It Down, is it like...?
Just Turn It Down. Turn everything down. Turn the music down, turn the level of the fridge down, save the environment, turn your personality down, you're getting on my tits. pin the blame on the drunkie. Just smash stuff in someone's house and blame it on the most drunk person there. So you bloody ran headfirst into that vase, didn't you? You didn't. I just threw it out the window. That's me at a party, innit? I'd had two baby shams.
OK. James, have you got a mascot this evening?
I have brought a mascot along with me. This is... Willoughby. Don't R him. He's a prick. I moved out of my parents' house, and after a month, I went back to say hello. And this was on the sofa. I said, who's that? She went, it's Willoughby. I went, what did you knit him? And she went, to replace you. It's literally my replacement. I hate him. I don't see how that's even... Look at his face. Not happy, is it? That's not... She made him a jacket as well. She's got a jacket for him. That he wears, just he lounges around the house.
It really
in
is house colours, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, yeah. Remember, it's meant to be. Look at that.
Oh, that's a lovely jacket.
That comes out. It's ridiculous.
What is that?
It's a little handkerchief for mopping his brow when he's had a tough day being a knobhead.
Thanks for sharing. Okay, Sarah, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have.
What did you bring?
I've got a bit of time off after this show, so I've got. A tool belt, like a time-off tool belt.
A time-off tool belt?
Yeah,
oh,
let me
the
just...
idea.
There we go. So that's what it looks like, that. So if I put it on... So this is so I can sit on the sofa and not have to move. Flask for tea, biscuits, telly remote, spare biscuits, a funnel in case I need a wee, and then a courgette. People say the cucumbers are better, but I don't agree. Just, you know, one of your five a day, Jimmy, that's what I mean.
Do it 5 times a day.
Yeah. you have to have different courgettes, because they just disintegrate after a while.
This is like the worst sex line ever. Can I speak to Barbara instead?
Presumably, if the remote control is there, your husband is at home having quite the shit evening.
like imagining him sitting there. Oh, there's no remote control. Oh, and she's taking the cord yet. What am I going to do? Board.
And I tell you what, that chocolate brownie I found in the fridge was off.
I love it. Well, I love the toolbar. It's a great idea. Lee, did you bring a mascot?
I decided I was going to bring my lucky buttons. They've been with me for a long time. They always bring me luck. I'm so organised as well. I've numbered my lucky buttons. I give them all a little number.
Can we see them?
My lucky buttons, so I'll be... lucky buttons, though. Yeah.
You can't have a calculator on the show, Lee.
Can I not use that, then?
No. Can't use a calculator.
What about my lucky letters? Can I use those?
If he can't use his mascot, does that mean I can't use my mascot?
Not the courgette, no. Do you know what? Who needs these things when you've got Sarah Milliken on your side? Can I keep hold of the dictionary?
Okay, John, have you got a mascot?
I've been in my lab a lot lately. Yeah. Been down in my lab.
I hope you don't mean your dog.
You'll rephrase that to avoid any ambiguity. I've been right up my spaniel the last couple of months. I've been in my lab looking for a solution to the energy crisis that's happening across the world. We're burning up all the fossil fuels. We're going to die. What is there an abundance of in the world? Well, smugness, Jimmy. And I found a way of transforming smugness into electricity. And I've watched back some of these shows and I can't help but notice that I think I'm a smug twat. So, this is... The other end of this lead is... in me. And I'm hoping at some point this evening, if I feel particularly proud of myself, the bulb will light and then we'll know that my studies have not been wasted.
So it's a light bulb powered by your smugness?
Yeah, but it's a light bulb today, but tomorrow it could be a Toyota Yaris.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's legendary performance poet Dr. John Cooper Clarke. Making a living from poetry isn't easy, which is why John supplements his income by standing in a field and scaring away crows. you are a renowned wordsmith. Have you got any favourite words, John?
They're all pretty good.
OK, and with John, of course, it's Susie Dent. Susie has a new book out called Dent's Modern Tribes, and congratulations are in order because it's number 3 on Amazon's chart, right between Nitol and Ketamine. Susie, we've got John on the show tonight. He's a legendary poet. Are there any rhyming words that you particularly like?
Well, John is expert at rhyme, and I was telling him how much I genuinely love his poetry, and there was one that I particularly liked, which he said he wrote for Valentine's Day, so...
It got out of hand.
It got out of hand. There are 4 lines that made me think of you, in fact, Jimmy.
Oh, go on.
I just scribbled them down. You've got this slippery quality. It makes me think of phlegm. And a dual personality. I hate both of them.
That's from your poem, Twat.
Yeah.
That's right.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel appeared on a celebrity version of Child Genius, where she was beaten by a 12-year-old in a maths challenge. And there's me thinking dancing on Strictly would have been the most embarrassing thing in your career. Rachel, where do you see yourself in 10 years?
Well, in 10 years, hopefully, I'll have been working in telly for 18 years. So I'll probably be testifying against someone I've worked with.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Fridge Freezer.
You should never climb in a fridge, do we?
I was
going
to
say
you need to do the warning about that, don't you?
The warning. If you're watching this, don't get in a fridge.
The problem with you saying it, Jimmy, is it sounds like a challenge.
OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for our first game. Lee, Sarah, you get the first pick of the letters.
Surely Sarah Lee.
are they still going, Sarah Lee Gattos?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, they're not just cakes either, all sorts of shit. They've become like a big company. I mean, it's probably not the... We can have this conversation in the bar afterwards if you want.
So this is a bit awkward. Do you think we're going for a drink? we'll start with a consonant, please.
Thank you, Lee.
Rachel.
M.
Vowel.
V.
Upside down.
It's your only job, Rachel.
Rachel, it's forgivable that you put it upside down, but it's not forgivable that you then thought it was a V. It's got a line through the middle of it.
How do we know that first one's not a W?
Yeah. Consonant.
In.
Consonant.
D.
Vowel.
O.
Consonant.
R.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant.
V. There we go.
Oh, sure it's not an A. vowel.
And the last one. U.
And for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. You, Sarah, would you like a car bar?
Yeah, yeah, okay.
It's delicious.
Ooh. Oh. John, I've got you a chocolate as well.
A Toblerone.
does this taste of you?
Put it in your mouth and see.
You should try first, because you've got the reference point.
Lee, what have you got?
This is nice, isn't it? The car's bars. Oh, it looks lovely on the outside, but I bet it's hollow in the middle.
How many letters?
Oh, please. Yeah, forgot about that. Right, start the clock, let's get on with it.
Lee, you're inhaling a chocolate bar.
I'm not getting any of this.
How much have you eaten?
I'm diabetic. It's just too good. It's either this or faint.
How many letters?
Five big ones.
Sarah?
I've got six.
John?
I've got seven.
And James?
Six.
OK, Lee, you're five.
Round.
Sarah, you're six.
Domain.
Hi, James.
My six is random.
OK, and John, you're seven.
I was hoping that a saviour whose name is Dave might be a Daviour.
Daviour?
No.
Well, 6 points to both teams.
Yay.
John Cooper Clark, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
They could have had a round.
Put the A on.
Oh, I didn't put the A on. Mm. Oh. What an idiot. It's weird, isn't it? You're all laughing, but you didn't think of it either, did you?
So at the end of that, both teams have 6 points. On to our first numbers round, OK? John, James, you get to pick the numbers.
Because there's two Johns on, you said, John, you're a sort of renowned poet earlier, and I thought you meant me. So I wondered if for the rest of the show I could be known as Rico.
Rico?
Yeah. I just think that'll save a lot of confusion, because it's the other name I go by.
Mm. You know with nicknames, normally other people give you the nickname and they use it a lot. You don't give it to yourself because you didn't have any friends when you were younger.
Jimmy, I would also like to be called Rico.
So your team would like to be Rico and Rico?
It's just how I feel. It's what I would like to be known as. Nothing is going to change my mind.
We're Rico and Rico.
Well, Rico and Rico, pick your numbers.
What, you want one big, two big, three big, four big?
I don't know what you just said.
Four big.
Oh, Jesus.
Four.
Seven.
100. 50, 25 and 75. And the target.
453.
OK, and your time starts now. OK, so the target was 453. John, did you get it? OK, James, did you get it?
I've got 54.
54?
Yep.
OK, and how did you get that?
100 times 7.
OK, all right. Sarah, did you get it?
Yes, I think so,
and
yes.
And Lee, did you get it?
I did it, yeah, I got it.
OK, Sarah, how did you get it?
4 times 100. It's 400 plus yep. 50.
450.
And 75 divided by 25 is 3, and add that on.
Yeah, well done.
Thanks.
John, how did you do it?
I got the same as she got, mate. I wrote it down. I used brackets and everything.
I'm amazed the light didn't go off with the brackets.
Well, it's temperamental, isn't it? I try really hard to be smug. I need a compliment.
Well,
and you're just not the guy. Which is why I've sought love elsewhere.
Hello.
Time to go across to Dictionary Corner. John Cooper Clark, have you got any poems for us?
I do. Thanks for asking, Jim. Yeah. This one's called Pies. It's about pies. A homely girl named Anne couldn't get a man. Her mother told her, darling, don't you cry. You'll knock 'em down like Skittles with some farinaceous victuals. You'll always get a guy with a pie. The salad's in the bin. I've never seen a gym, but I'll be there to watch those fuckers die. Mincemeat or steak, it's better than a cake. You'll always get a guy with a pie. Even when they're stale, they taste okay with ale at the point where hunger pangs intensify. Cold weather grub, available in the public house. You'll always get a pie-eyed guy with a pie. You'll always get a guy with a pie. What else you gonna do with that leftover stew and those cuts of meat you can't identify? Ingredients of this sort just taste better under short crust. You'll always get a guy with a I spy with my little eye, something beginning with oh I. You'll always get a guy with a pie.
The scores at the moment, Lee and Sarah have 16, John and James have 16. And here is your teaser. The words are moist one. The clue is you might need a tissue. That's moist one. You might need a tissue. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were moist one. The clue was you might need a tissue. It was, of course, emotions. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Lee and James. So,
oh,
James,
right, bring it
your
on.
Turn to pick the letters.
Thank you. Can I have a vowel, please?
You can, James. E.
Can we put it in the middle, though?
Go on.
Thank you. Consonant, please. It's at the end, please.
This one, N.
Consonant, second from the end.
L.
Consonant at the start.
S.
Vowel in the middle.
I.
Vowel after S.
O.
Consonant before L.
G.
Consonant before the E.
T.
And do what you like for the other one.
And
live your life,
an
Rachel.
R.
Okay, and your time starts now. Ooh.
Thank you.
Lee? Lee, what have you got? Lee, what have you got?
I've got... just give me a second, I'm a bit thrown. I've got two from the bottom, one in the middle.
I don't, it makes my balls jiggle.
Nine.
OK. James, how many?
I have two words that go together and make a sentence.
What is the longest of the words that you've got using those letters?
Five.
Five. What's your five?
The longer this is going on for, the angrier that looks.
Your five?
Riots.
Riots. OK, and Lee, your nine?
I think I'm a T-short.
What did you think you had?
I thought I had a big penis. I'm gonna go for nine. I know there's a T missing, but I'll go for it anyway. Re-slotting.
Give me two T's.
5 points to James then. I might go and put my clothes on.
No point covering yourself up now, mate.
I've got a seven. I know I wasn't playing, but could I? Because then maybe I could turn this mug machine on.
What was your seven?
Sorting.
Yep.
You mean, yeah, I think we know it's a word.
Who was that man?
What, sorry?
Who was that man? And how do you know him?
It's a good question, Jimmy.
That was me.
The problem is, Jimmy, he was facing us, and we know he neither had your face or your penis.
How many times did everyone look at it?
I looked at it a lot.
I looked at it once, but continuously the whole time.
Do you feel bad that you stared at the man's...
I found looking at his cock less awkward than looking at his face. When I looked at his cock didn't have an expression that said, "Oh, my face is hanging out."
I mean, it's bad enough being Jimmy Carr's genitals, but being Jimmy Carr's genitals double, I mean, that's too much, isn't it?
Oh, listen to him, boys. Could they have done any better?
Are the two boys down there again?
John Cooper Clarke, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
They could have got Sterling and ringlets.
OK, so at the end of that, Lee and Sarah have 16, John and James have 21. Now time for John and Sarah to go head-to-head. Sarah, your turn to pick the numbers.
Oh, can I have two large and four small?
You can indeed.
Thanks, love.
Two big, four little, and they are five. One. Another one. Ooh. Four. Ooh. 125. And the target, 599.
Thank you.
And your time starts now. How smug is he going to be, though? I mean... Oh, we got it within 10 seconds. That can't be good, can it? John, did you get it? I noticed the light's on.
Well, I just remembered that guy's dick.
Sarah.
Hang on, I just remembered that guy's dick.
Oh my God.
Honestly, it was massive. I'm pretty smug. You're not getting smugger than that, do you? Yeah. Oh God, I pressed the wrong button. I'm sorry.
Did you get it, Sarah?
Yes, I did.
Go on, how did you do it?
100 times 5 is 500.
500.
25 times 4 is 100.
Yep.
500 minus the 100... sorry, add the 100 and then minus the 1.
Lovely. 599.
Thanks, love.
Perfect. Yeah. I'm going to guess... Did you do it in exactly the same way?
No, I didn't. No, I did 5 plus 1 is 6.
Yep.
And then times by 100.
600.
And then took 1 off.
Yep. Lovely.
If that was still operational, I imagine it would be glowing brightly now.
Yeah. That guy's dick just ruined this whole show.
That's for me!
OK.
10 points to both teams. Time now to go back to Dictionary Corner. John Cooper Clarke, do you have another poem for us?
Yes, I do, Jimmy. This particular one is set in a mythical Oldham. Why mythical? It has to be that way because I've never been to Oldham. I'm from Manchester, so why would I? It's in the opposite direction to everywhere I wanted to go. Whenever Oldham, the subject of Oldham comes up, it's usually on the news every so often. It's never good. So I figure it needs a little help in the public relations area. I'm sure Oldham is anxious to be seen as a modern go-ahead city. Probably got a town motto, reversing into the future together, something like that. It's not twinned with anywhere, but it's got a suicide pact with Gdansk. The news is never good. So I thought it needs a little of the old poetical, magical, oofle dust sprinkling over it to drag it kicking and screaming into the mid-20th century. Right. Trouble at Mall. Daily Bugle, front page news. A drunken posse on a booze cruise. Swear me in, I got nothing to lose. High five, low morale. Trouble I, trouble I, trouble at Mall. I heard about it at the Taj Mahal. I nearly choked on me Tarkadel. I quizzed Chief Wiggum and he said, wow. Cuff and boys, trouble at the mouth. Tripst and bloody fell over. Savour the level of drama in that one line. Tripst and bloody fell over. It's covered the place in a beefy odour. Better take a nosegay, pal. Trouble I, trouble I, trouble at Mal. Bury my heart at Clinton Cards. Remember me to the old guard. These days you just gotta be hard, cos like they say in this here locale, trouble I, trouble I, trouble at Mal. H&M is full of flunkies, and Tony and Guy couldn't give a monkeys. In the dying words of Gore Vidal, happen it's trouble, aye, trouble at Mal.
OK, was the line where you said savour the line part of the poem, or was that...
No, no,
you, you'd broken the fourth wall to come back in?
No, it hit me for suddenly.
OK, and here is your teaser. The words are taste poo, and the clue is I have it with every meal. That's taste poo, I have it with every meal. See you after the break. Back. The answer to the teaser, the words were taste poo. The clue was I have it with every meal. It was, of course, potatoes. OK, before we go on, a chance for our teams to win some bonus points in honour of the great John Cooper Clarke. I've asked the players to write poems. They're going to perform them now. Obviously, John will be judging, and whoever comes up with the best poem, their team will get 5 bonus points. OK, John, you're up first.
Well, this is a poem about my favourite TV programme, but I don't reveal what the programme is till the end, so you have to try and work it out as the poem's going on.
That's great, cos I watch a lot of Sally.
Right, good. Well, there's clues as it builds, so see if you can work out what the programme is. Hey, guys, time to put your mount down. Leave the Queen to shout crown in her in-or-out gown. Turn the lights off all about town. Stop drinking port or you'll end up with gout, clown. Switch to Guinness, then in stout drown. It's a showdown, time to slow down. I'm one rhyme off a breakdown, so put the TV remote down because now it's time for Bake Off.
John Cooper Clarke, what do you think?
I think that was fantastic. I love the... what was the clown one? What,
you're stop get drinking port or you'll end up with gout clown.
Gout clown. That's the one that got me. Fantastic. And the...
I nearly repeated that line because of the drama in it.
Yeah, because of the... I don't see why you would do that. Yeah. Yeah, gout clown. It's one of them diseases you never get any sympathy for, isn't it? Yeah. You know, oh, I've got gout. Lay off the stilt, you greedy bastard. Put the knife and fork there. So, just for mentioning gout, you're in the top three.
OK, James, your poem, please.
Thank you. My poem is about Oldham. No, this poem, genuinely, I wrote this when I was 8 years old and I won a competition with it in primary school.
Get out of here.
Yeah, man. Untitled.
Pretentious.
There were four pandas in a bed and the little one said, "We are all that's left."
John Cooper Clarke, your comments.
Great, it's great that, James, but that's that gout clown thing. Really. What is it? It's a build up of uric acid in the joint.
Yeah. They're animals and they're on the verge of extinction.
You know, they're not as extinct as they've been leading us to believe. They move about a lot. They're always playing the victim card when it comes to pandas.
OK. Sarah, do you have a poem for us?
Yes, I do. I also wrote this when I was at school. I was 9, so a little bit older than James. It's my Christmas poem, and it goes like this. Christmas is a lot of fun and Santa Claus has just begun to wrap a presents, lots of toys, all wrapped together for girls and boys. There are presents bright and bold, there are presents you can hold.
What was that last one?
There are presents you can hold.
All right, yeah.
I mean, there's others that are just like concepts. The next morning when you rise, you never ever get a surprise until that morning, Christmas Day, when everyone is happy, jolly and gay. The end.
Perfectly charming. I like to be encouraging. I don't like saying rotten things about
No, well, bless you for that. Thank you.
But on the other hand, I don't want to be too encouraging.
On the other hand, it's shit.
OK, Lee, I believe you've written a poem.
I have written a poem, yeah.
Well, let's hear it.
I've known you for quite a while now, Jimmy. I wanted a way of trying to tell you how I felt about you. So I've written a poem.
Well, that's lovely.
And this is just for you, Jimmy.
Sure.
There once was a fat kid called Jimmy. Who went all showbiz and got skinny. His white teeth are drastic, his wig's made of plastic, and his money's kept offshore in New Guinea.
Well, you paint a vivid picture, Luke.
Is there any chance you felt the drama?
I did. I felt your pain all the way.
Who do you think? Who are the points going to?
I'm giving it to John on account of the gout line.
5 points to John. OK, on with the game. Lee and Sarah, your turn to choose the letters.
Do you want to go this time?
Okie dokie. Hi, love. Can I have a consonant, please?
M.
A vowel, please, Rachel.
A.
Thank you. Another consonant?
S.
Another consonant, please?
R.
A vowel, please.
E.
Another vowel, please.
U.
A consonant.
N.
Another consonant.
L.
And a vowel, please.
And the last one. O.
Thank you.
OK, and your time starts now. So, Lee, how many letters?
At the moment, not literally, not one. I haven't got one letter word.
Well, that's funny, cos one is in there.
Oh, yeah.
James, how many?
Six.
Six. John?
Seven.
Sarah?
Six.
You're six. What's your six, Sarah?
Arouse.
Yeah, a little bit, yeah. James, you're six?
Manure.
John?
Moaners.
Yeah.
Just Mona. 7 points to John, then. Ah. There you go. John Cooper Clark, Susie Dent, the goth couple getting married. could they have done any better?
2 8s. Numerals and enamels.
OK, so the scores at the moment, Lee and Sarah have 26, John and James have 43. And here is your teaser. The words are microsex. The clue is somebody call a priest. That's microsex, somebody call a priest. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were microsex. The clue was somebody call a priest. It was, of course, exorcism. OK, time for our final letters game. John, James, your turn to choose the letters.
A vowel, please.
E.
Consonant, please.
G.
A vowel, please.
A.
Consonant, please.
M.
A vowel, please.
I.
A. Consonant, please.
F.
A consonant, please.
S.
A vowel, please.
E.
Another vowel, please.
Oh. And crazy stuff.
Naughty boy.
Oh.
OK, and your time starts now. I was going to step in there, but I think they did all right. You know what you should do? Check yourself before you wreck yourself. John, how many?
Six.
Six, OK. James?
A risky six.
A risky six, I like it.
Yeah.
Lee?
A fairly safe six. I'm not like that loser. I've got faith in the product.
Five letters.
No, not that, I know that's five. You know, I'm not very good at anagrams, but I can count. I'd like to change it to five, please.
You six?
I've got a six.
OK, Sharon?
Five.
What was your five?
Games.
Lee, your six?
Geomes.
Geomes. Could you use that in a sentence?
Yeah.
Yes. How would you define geomes?
Well, if I saw my mate Holmes, and I wasn't expecting him, I'd go, geomes. Geomes is a word. It doesn't matter what. Susie, they don't have to go to Susie. I'm telling you that geomes is a word.
Susie, is that a word? It looks like it might be.
Yeah, it does look like it might be, but there's loads of geomatics.
Yeah, well, that's what it's to do with geomatics. It's okay. Geomes.
It just, you just need to use it more often and then it will go in.
Good. Well,
yeah.
John, you're six.
Images. Or I also had figami, which is the ancient Japanese art of folding figs.
James.
My risky six. I mean, none of you will know him, but there's a kid in my class called Sam Fogg.
And that was your risky six, was the name Sam Fogg?
Yeah, well, I don't know how many people know him these days. I only had one lesson with him.
6 points to John. John, Susie, could they have done any better?
Sixes were the best, really.
Sixes, yeah, all the way.
OK, so Lee and Sarah have 26, John and James have 49. Sarah, Lee, what? You're playing just for pride.
Not just pride, but one piece of Toblerone.
OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Your time starts now.
Is it? Oh, it's not that.
I can tell you, you're correct, it is not that. OK?
Oh, yeah. birthdays.
I did my light go on.
Oh, hang on, Lee, you buzzed in, but James buzzed in. What do you think it is?
I might be wrong. I think it might be birthdays, Jimmy.
Well, let's have a look and see if it's up there. Oh, it's birthdays. So the final scores are Lee and Sarah have 36 points, but tonight's winners with 29, John and James. Congratulations, you are now the proud owners of this, the Countdown Fridge Freezer. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
And one of tonight's cats is back on Friday at 10, recorded live at the Brighton Dome, Sarah Millican, Outsider. Tomorrow at 10, let's hope a nervous rugby player doesn't drop the ball in First Dates.
Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, a baby porcupine is called a porcupet? Porcupet is also a chat-up line in Newcastle. Tolkien typed the 1,200-page manuscript of Lord of the Rings using only two fingers. I bet that was bloody Mordor. And amen is the last word in the Bible. God says it, and then he drops the mic and crowd surfs out on a bunch of lepers. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's John Richardson. John recently filmed a documentary about irrational fears. What if they're not irrational, John? What if you are boring and everyone does hate you? And John's teammate, James Acaster. Thank you. Where would James be without comedy? Well, I imagine hanging out at a games workshop wondering what it's like to touch a girl's boob.
I'm still doing half of those things.
Up against them is special guest team captain Lee Mack.
Hi.
Lee excelled at school. Sorry, Lee was expelled at school. And joining Lee tonight, Sarah Millican. Hello. Sarah founded the online feminist magazine Standard Issue. If you want to check it out, ladies, it's easy. Just get your husband or your dad to set it up on the computer for you. Well, if that got me in trouble, I might as well go all in. OK.
The classic Jimmy Carr catchphrase.
You set up Standard Issue, right?
Yes.
Well, tell us a little bit about it. What is it?
Oh, it's a no-bullshit women's magazine. Cos I don't like women's magazines generally. Cos I don't care about the things that they write about. So we set up one that has things that our women are interested in, which is, you know, everything.
So a no-bullshit women's magazine... Cos normal women's magazines have just got... It's kind of... It's just adverts for bags. Like, if you buy Vogue...
Do you buy women's... Well, you maybe you do, cos you could get tips on how to creosote your face, for example.
Well, if I go on it, will they know that I'm a man having a sneaky peek?
I don't know why
I've
you
been
would...
on it, they can't tell.
Well, it's levels of testosterone, so maybe you'd be all right.
OK, Sarah is from the northeast, and fun fact, human beings share 99.9% of our DNA with Geordies.
I'm technically a sand dancer, so South Shields.
But a also, sand dancer?
Yeah, but it sounds rubbish, doesn't it?
My hometown is Southport, and they are the sand grounders. Just,
oh, not, really?
Not all comedy, some of it's information.
My hometown is Lancaster, and we call ourselves Lancastrians because we don't like to take the piss.
James, where are you from and what do they call you lot?
I'm from Kettering and they call us legends.
Okay, Lee, I mean, you strike me as quite a wise man. What's your motto in life?
Well, I've got quite a few, actually, Jim. I've got quite a lot of mottos. First of all, my motto in life is never put off until tomorrow what can be put off until the day after tomorrow. never return to a lit firework unless you're pretty sure it's probably gone out. Girls do just want to have fun, but apparently not with me. and finally, if life gives you lemons, say, I'm sorry, life, I didn't ask for lemons. I asked for a hot girlfriend in a speedboat.
I mean, all good. Sarah, you recently tweeted about unblocking a toilet with a bath mat.
That's a good one, isn't it?
How did you...?
Well, all you need to unblock a toilet is basically creating a vacuum. And I just got the, you know, the bath mat, and I just sort of did that a bit, and it... And
was, then it I just... the, was it rubber?
Yeah. Yeah, it wasn't like a fluffy
So you get... Because you need purchase, don't you? You need a bit of something...
And then you just cover the hole, and you just do that for ages, and then... All good, and then you just, you know, chuck the bath mat in the bath.
Have you got any other housekeeping tips? Any other?
This is a good one.
Okay, go on.
If you ever have to keep a dog poo in your fridge, I've had to because the dog wasn't very well, so I had to take samples 3 days in a row. So you have to keep the first two fresh before you take them to the vet. Makes total sense. And I thought, well, whereabouts in the fridge? And then I realised salad crisper because there's never anything in it.
Okay. James, is it fair to say you're a bit of an oddball?
Clearly not. I'm pretty cool. Pretty happening guy in most of my circles. If I venture outside of those borders, opinions vary.
Do you think you're cooler than John?
Here's something you got to know early doors, Jimmy. Coolness is not a competition. Me and John, we hit the town sometimes together.
Ooh.
In the daytime to do some shopping. Best time to hit the town, with everyone's there and the shops are open and everyone knows our name at certain shops.
Well, that's because you're probably wearing name tags.
We do wear name tags. And do you know what? Once, do you remember this? We swapped them around for a laugh. His name's not James.
I didn't realise he would be such a titty toucher.
Guilty!
OK, John, what's your favourite party game?
Oh, Turn It Down.
What's Turn It Down, is it?
Just turn it down. Turn everything down. Turn the music down, turn the level of the fridge down. Save the environment, turn your personality down, you're getting on my tits. pin the blame on the drunkie. Just smash stuff in someone's house and blame it on the most drunk person there. So you bloody ran headfirst into that vase, didn't you? You didn't, I just threw it out the window. That's me at a party, innit? I'd had two baby shams.
OK. James, have you got a mascot this evening?
I have brought a mascot along with me. This is... Willoughby. Don't R him, he's a prick. I moved out of my parents' house and after a month I went back to say hello and this was on the sofa. I said, who's that? She went, it's Willoughby. I went, why did you knit him? And she went, to replace you. literally my replacement. I hate him. I don't see how that's even... Look at his face. Not happy, is it? That's not... She made him a jacket as well. She's got a jacket for him that he wears. Just he lounges around the house
it
in
really
this.
It really is house colours, isn't it?
Yeah, well, yeah. Remember who it's meant to be. Look at that.
Oh, that's a lovely jacket.
That comes out. It's ridiculous.
What is that?
It's a little handkerchief for mopping his brow when he's had a tough day being a knobhead.
Thanks for sharing. OK, Sarah, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have.
What did you bring?
I've got a bit of time off after this show. So I've got a tool belt, like a time-off tool belt.
A time-off tool belt?
Yeah,
oh,
let me
the
just...
idea.
There we go. So that's what it looks like, that. So if I put it on... So this is so I can sit on the sofa and not have to move. Flask for tea, biscuits, a telly remote, spare biscuits, a funnel in case I need a wee, and then a courgette. People say their cucumbers are better, but I don't agree. Just, you know, what do you... Only a five a day, Jimmy, that's what I mean.
Yeah, you do it five times a day?
Yeah. you have to have different courgettes, because they just disintegrate after a while.
This is like the worst sex line ever. Can I speak to Barbara instead?
Presumably, if the remote control is there, your husband is at home having quite the shit evening.
I like imagining him sitting there, oh, there's no remote control. Oh, and she's taking the courgette. What am I going to do? Board.
And I tell you what, that chocolate bounty I found in the fridge was off.
I love it. Well, I love the tool belt. It's a great idea. Lee, did you bring a mascot?
I decided I was going to bring my lucky buttons. They've been with me for a long time. They always bring me luck. I'm so organised as well, I've numbered my lucky buttons. I give them all a little number.
Can we see them?
My lucky buttons, so I'll be...
You can't have a calculator on the show, Lee.
Can I not use that then?
No. Can't use a calculator.
What about my lucky letters? Can I use those?
if he can't use his mascot, does that mean I can't use my mascot?
Not the courgette, no.
Who needs
these things when you've got Sarah Milliken on your side? Can I keep hold of the dictionary?
Okay, John, have you got a mascot?
I've been in my lab a lot lately. Yeah. Been down in my lab.
I hope you don't mean your dog.
I shall rephrase that to avoid any ambiguity. I've been right up my spaniel the last couple of months. I've been in my lab looking for a solution to the energy crisis that's happening across the world. We're burning up all the fossil fuels, we're going to die. What is there an abundance of in the world? Well, smugness, Jimmy. And I found a way of transforming smugness into electricity. And I've watched back some of these shows and I can't help but notice that I think I'm a smug twat. So, this is... The other end of this lead is... in me. And I'm hoping at some point this evening, if I feel particularly proud of myself, the bulb will light and then we'll know that my studies have not been wasted.
So it's a light bulb powered by your smugness?
Yeah, but it's a light bulb today, but tomorrow it could be a Toyota Yaris.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's legendary performance poet Dr. John Cooper Clarke. Making a living from poetry isn't easy, which is why John supplements his income by standing in a field and scaring away crows. you are a renowned wordsmith. Have you got any favourite words, John?
They're all pretty good.
OK, and with John, of course, it's Susie Dent! Susie has a new book out called Dent's Modern Tribes, and congratulations are in order because it's number 3 on Amazon's chart, right between Nitol and Ketamine. Susie, we've got John on the show tonight. He's a legendary poet. Are there any rhyming words that you particularly like?
Well, John is expert at rhyme, and I was telling him how much I genuinely love his poetry. And there was one that I particularly liked, which he said he wrote for Valentine's Day. So
it got out of hand.
It got out of hand. The four lines that made me think of you, in fact, Jimmy.
Oh, go on.
I just scribbled them down. You've got this slippery quality. It makes me think of phlegm and a dual personality. I hate both of them.